Now, the consideration of petitions filed before the Supreme Court challenging the Gazette notification on the dissolution of Parliament commenced this morning before a panel of 7 Supreme Court justices. The 7-judge bench comprises of Chief Justice Nalin Pereira, Justices Bhuvana Kalubiharia, Cicero Diabro, Priyamta Jayawardena, Prasanna Jayawardena, Vijit Malalgoda, and Murdo Fernando.
13 petitions were filed with the Supreme Court challenging the Gazette notification issued by President Maithripala Sirisena dissolving Parliament, while several others appeared as intervenient parties. On the 13th of November, the Supreme Court issued an interim order staying the operation of the Gazette notification on the dissolution of Parliament. The Chief Justice nominated a fuller bench comprising of Chief Justice Nalin Pereira, Justices Bhuvana Kalubihare, Cicero Diabro, Priyanta Jayawardena, Prasanna Jayawardena, and Murdo Fernando of the Supreme Court to hear the fundamental rights petition following a request made by parliamentarian Udaya Gammanpilla. President's Counsel K. Kanagiswaran, Tilak Marapana, Jayampathi Vikramaratna, and Attorney at Law Viran Correa and M.A. Sumanthiran appeared for the petitioners and made lengthy submissions. They claim the Gazette notification issued by the President on the dissolution of Parliament is unconstitutional and should be declared null and void. The Council further stated that the President only has the power to dissolve the Parliament under Article 70, Subsection 1 of the 19th Amendment to the Constitution in a situation when the country faces serious danger or when there are riots and a situation that jeopardizes the everyday life of the people. Councils argued that a two-thirds majority in Parliament is needed if Parliament is to be dissolved. If not, the order is null and void. The petitioners point out that due to the President's arbitrary and autocratic actions, the fundamental rights of the people have been violated. President's Counsel Tilak Marapan has stated that just because one gives a license to drive, it does not mean that he can drive as he pleases. One must always drive abiding by the road rules and giving priority to the passengers and others. He further stated that the 19th Amendment limited the powers of the President and that he does not have a power to remove the Prime Minister from office at his discretion, and the Cabinet should be appointed under the advice of the Prime Minister. Counsel Viran Correa stated that the President is a position created by the Constitution and as such he should act within his limits. 10 UPFA MPs who are attorneys have filed a petition with the Supreme Court requesting to appear as interveners on the matter of the petitions that are filed challenging the dissolution of Parliament. The petitioners are Anurup Priyadarshan Yapa, Pravithra Vanyarachi, WDJ Senivirathna, Priyani Vijay Vikrama, Sisira Jayakodi, Chandrasiri Gajadira, Lakshman Vasanta Pereira, Dilan Pereira, Anuruddha Jayaratna, and Chandima Veera Kodi.